Archaeology is an interesting subject, but not all archaeology qualifies as being interesting. On this channel, we're interested only in the most informative, incredible, and surprising discoveries from the world of archaeology, those that literally stand out from the crowd. When that happens, we call it outstanding archaeology, and that's the subject of this video. Stand by because you're about to see some exceptional discoveries and learn some surprising things. For a long time, archaeologists and historians have wondered why there's a strange red wheel painted onto the ceiling of Pinwheel Cave in Southern California, apparently put there around 400 years ago by Native Americans. Now they believe they have the answer, and it's one they didn't expect. If the results of a study performed in October 2020 are correct, the red wheel is a drawing of a hallucinogenic plant strategically placed to heighten the psychedelic experiences of people who just consumed its real-life equivalent. The theory is supported by the discovery of the remains of chewed plants crammed into cracks and crevices within the cave. The plant is called Datura and has been used by humans for its psychoactive properties for hundreds of years. Pinwheel Cave is, in one of a better phrase, a place where Native Americans came to get high and experience visions, probably in groups and perhaps even with their families. These psychedelic trips weren't purely recreational. The visions that were experienced during it were believed to provide perspective on both the present and the future. The basic definition of a meteorite is a lump of rock that falls to Earth after becoming trapped in our planet's gravity field. They can come from anywhere, but the majority of them are either broken pieces of comets or asteroids, or in some cases, chunks of the moon. In 2013, though, an asteroid was found on Earth that's believed to be the first of its kind, a lump of rock from Mercury. Known as NWA 7325 and sporting an unusual green color, the meteorite was discovered in Morocco. Scientists don't know how long it's been there, but the rock itself appears to be a little over 4.5 billion years old. The giveaway that it's from Mercury is its low magnetic intensity, which is a close match for Mercury's low magnetism, but is unlike anything that occurs on Earth naturally. The asteroid's rocky surface might actually be equivalent to scum forming on the top of a pool, only in this case, it's rock that formed on the surface of cooled magma. The meteorite was probably chipped away from Mercury by an enormous impact that occurred billions of years ago. And it might not even be the only one to have landed on Earth. There might be more out there. If ancient humans developed a sense of expressionism and artistry in the ancient world, they began to make paintings and sculptures. Some of the earliest carvings and paintings on the planet are of humans and animals because it made sense for these ancient artists to draw and recreate things they saw around them. Here are a couple of Stone Age art pieces for your viewing pleasure, a figurine of a buffalo, and another of a pig from Tel Motza, Israel. Scientists have tested the objects and confirmed that they were created around 9,500 years ago. Both of the artifacts were discovered during the widening of a highway in the area. The people of the time were beginning to transition from nomadic hunter-gatherers to setting up permanent and semi-permanent homes and keeping animals for farming and grazing. These small sculptures might be related to that new farming tradition, or alternatively, they were created purely because there was nothing else to do at the time other than watch animals and chip away at rocks. Whether they're talismans or ornaments, they're an interesting reminder of much simpler times for human civilizations. The phrase live, laugh, love appears regularly on cushions, posters, t-shirts, and other places in our modern world. And sometimes we laugh at it because of the simplicity of its message. Well, perhaps we shouldn't be so quick to mock it, though, because it's one of the most commonly repeated sentiments known to humankind. It even appears on this 4th century Roman glass vase, which was found in Autun, France in November 2020. If we interpret the inscription literally, it says live happily, but the sentiment is close enough. Vases like this one are exceptionally rare discoveries. It's only the 10th of its kind to be found, and the first in almost 50 years. The vessel is made from reticulated glass, which represents ancient Roman artisans and glassmakers at the pinnacle of their profession. There might yet be more to come from Otten in terms of remarkable discoveries. Archaeologists have been working at the site for most of 2020 and have so far opened and explored more than 230 graves within the enormous necropolis. Even before it belonged to the Roman Empire, it was part of the Celtic territory known as Gaul. So there could be treasures to be found at the site that predate Roman occupation. Rope making is an ancient and important human tradition and skill. We still use it today, and we'll continue to use it for as long as human beings find purposes for rope. But it might surprise you to learn just how far back in time the tradition goes. Here's an example of a rope making tool that was created more than 40,000 years ago. The tool, which was found in Germany in 2016, is carved from mammoth ivory and features four holes drilled into its surface, each with a different diameter. While the possibility that this might have been an ancient musical instrument was briefly considered, experts now believe that it's more likely to have been used to make rope out of plant fibers. The precisely cut nature of these spiral drilled holes even shows that our ancient ancestors could make ropes of different thicknesses, depending on what they needed to have them used for. The team has provided strong evidence to support their theory, including a video demonstration of how the holes would be used to make rope. So it appears that the question of how rope was made during the Paleolithic era has finally been answered. Rock shrines are common in the central and southern parts of India, but they're far less common in the north part of the country. In fact, there's only one place you'll find them, and that's the Masroor temples. They're incredible creations, carved directly into the rock and ornately decorated. But nobody knows who built them or why. They're not even really sure when the work was done, although most estimates point towards either the 7th or 8th centuries. There are 15 Saqqara temples at the site, surrounding a rectangular pool of water at the center. Also at the center, you'll find a shrine dedicated to Sita, Laxman, and Ram, featuring representations of all three deities. The rock here is in sandstone, which is one of the easier forms of stone to work with, but creating works this intricate would still be a challenge for us today with our technology. It's hard to imagine how people went without the task more than 1,300 years ago. If they were using stone hand tools, it must have taken them decades to finish the site. Some of the world's best-known archaeological sites are so big that even now, years after they were found, new discoveries are still being made. Angkor in Cambodia has been explored and studied hundreds of times over the years, and yet until June 2020, nobody noticed this rather charming statue of a turtle at Kandal Sra Srang Temple. Based on its location, archaeologists suspect that the 2-foot by 3-foot turtle sculpture might have been placed as an offering as the temple's foundations were being laid during the early 10th century. While Angkor wasn't strictly a Hindu site, it was heavily influenced by Hindu culture. So when occasions called for a good luck charm to be placed in a strategic location, the charms were often drawn from Hindu ideology. In the case of this turtle, it would be seen as a symbol of prosperity and longevity. Sadly, it doesn't appear to have worked. There's virtually nothing left of the temple that once stood above it. Since being found, the turtle has been slowly excavated and then removed from the site with the intention of exhibiting it in a museum soon. Very occasionally, an archaeologist will make a discovery that appears to be impossible based on what we know about human history. This small sculpture of a human head made from mammoth ivory is one such discovery. It's a striking and accomplished work of art for something that's only 3.5 inches tall. But it's the object's age that's truly shocking. If scientists in the Czech Republic are to be believed, this artifact is 28,000 years old. The sculpture, which is curved at the base and might have been designed to fit around the top of a staff, was found at Brno in 1891, but wasn't dated until 2015. The same test revealed that it had been dipped in horse glue to preserve the bone and cut into shape using flint tools. Around the nostrils and the eyes, there's evidence that paraffin was used as a protective covering. This is an exceptional level of sophistication and totally at odds with what we think we know about the people who lived in Europe almost 30,000 years ago. Whoever made this must have been among the greatest artists of the ancient world. The River Thames in England has been the lifeblood of the city of London for centuries, bringing in trade and helping the city become one of the world's richest. All manner of goods have become stuck in its muddy banks over the years, and in 2015, archaeologists were excited to find a small cluster of golden goods embedded together. They were even more excited when they took a closer look at the items, because it appears that they may all have once been part of the same hat, made in the 16th century during England's Tudor period. The hat has long since rotted away, but the golden trinkets that adorned it have survived the passing of the past 500 years. According to historian and archaeologist Kate Sumnaugh, it's possible that the hat was blown off the head of someone crossing the river on a ferry. That would have been a very expensive loss for that unfortunate individual if her theory is correct. While the item's gold content isn't especially high, they're inlaid with colored glass and enamel, which would have made them appear both more beautiful and more valuable. They're now in the hands of the British Museum. We live in a state of constant amazement at the sophistication of the Maya, a civilization that seemed to have been almost impossibly advanced for the time they lived in. One of the most recent examples of their technological advancement is the discovery of a water filtration system in the city of Tikal, which used methods that are comparable with the kind of systems we still use today. The city, which is in northern Guatemala, was built approximately 2,300 years ago, with the Corriental Reservoir added around a century later. The system used zeolite and crystalline quartz to filter out microbes and heavy metals and remained in use until the 11th century. These are the same minerals we use in water filtration systems in the 21st century, meaning that if the Mayans were still living in Tikal, their ancient filtration system would probably still be working. Until this fascinating site was discovered, it was believed that the first use of zeolite in water filtration didn't occur until the 20th century. Now we know that the Mayans beat those 20th century inventors to the punch by 2,000 years. When archaeologists, historians, and scientists can't come up with answers to the questions posed by ancient artifacts between them, sometimes they turn to the public for help. We saw that happen in mid-2017 when the National Museum of Chinese Writing in Anyang, China offered a reward equivalent to $15,000 for help in translating their infamous Oracle Bone script, which is believed to contain secrets about life in China during the days of the Shang Dynasty. The characters, carved into ox bones, are thought to have been used by soothsayers to make predictions about the future. 5,000 different symbols have been identified on the bones, but only about 2,000 thus far have been translated, meaning that the translations of entire scripts is currently impossible. From what has been translated, we can see many references to specific people and places, but without the context surrounding them, the references are meaningless. It's thought that the soothsaying process worked by heating the bones until they cracked. A soothsayer then interpreted the cracks as answers to questions and wrote over the tops of the cracks to record the answers in an easier-to-understand format. It's been over a century since the first of the bones were found, so if you can assist with the research, you'll be helping to solve a very long-running mystery. It's often said that to understand a person, you have to walk a mile in their shoes. So how much can we really tell about a person from their shoes? Well, that depends on the shoe and where it's found. In this case, it's a 5,500-year-old shoe from Armenia, discovered inside a cave in June 2010. It's thought to be the oldest leather shoe in the world. This humble piece of footwear was made from a single piece of cowhide and molded to perfectly fit its owner's foot roughly 1,000 years before the pyramids of Giza were built. Oddly, the shoe was stuffed full of grass when it was discovered, Archaeologists are divided on whether the grass kept the shoe warm when it was being worn or helped it keep its shape after being taken off. They also don't know whether it was worn by a man or a woman. It's a 7 in American women's sizes, but as the men of the time were much smaller than they are today, that doesn't necessarily confirm anything. To answer our original question, we suppose you can't really find much out about a person from their shoes at all, other than the fact that leather shoes have apparently remained in fashion for several millennia. Subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications, and you will be the first to know when a new video comes out. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.